Hello, grade 12. Our lesson today about the angles and their measure. An angle is determined by rotating a ray about its end points. The starting position is called initial side. Ending position is called terminal side. Okay, standard position for any angle. Vertex is at the origin and the initial side is on the axis. Okay, as shown in figure. Okay, the difference between positive angle and negative angle. Positive angle are generated by counterclockwise. Counterclockwise. Negative angles generated by clockwise. Okay. For example, negative 45. Negative 45, as shown in figure, we rotate clockwise. This is initial side, so we rotate clockwise. Okay. Angles are often named using the following Greek letters: alpha, beta, theta. Also can named by traditional letters like A, B, C. What is the meaning of coterminal angles? Coterminal angles, angles that have same initial and terminal side. Initial and terminal side. Look at this figure. Alpha and beta both have initial side and terminal side. Second figure also, alpha and beta have the same initial and terminal side. Coterminal. Determine two coterminal angles, one positive and one negative for 60 degree. Coterminal, we start from this initial side and rotate. Okay, rotate 260 or one revolution, we get the equivalent angle to 60. Okay, by using this formula, 60 plus 360 or 60 minus 360. 60 plus one revolution or 60 minus one revolution. So, positive angle will equivalent to 60. 420, negative angle equivalent to 60 equal negative 300. Okay, give two coterminal angles, 30 plus one revolution, 30 minus one revolution. So the equivalent angle to 30 degree are 390 and negative 330 degree. Give coterminal angle, one positive and one negative. By using our relation, the angle plus one revolution or the angle minus one revolution. Okay, so the two equivalent angle to 230 are 590 and negative 130. Also for negative 20 plus 360 minus 360, the two coterminal angle. 2 negative 20, 1 positive and 1 negative, 340 and negative 380. In case we have angle greater than 360, to get one positive angle equivalent to 460, we can make minus, not plus. If we make plus 360, we get 820 degree. Good, but not the best. Okay, when the angle greater than 360, make minus for first one time. 460 minus 360 equal 100, so 100 equivalent to 460 degree. Okay, then take 100 and make minus make it minus, subtract 100 minus 360, we get negative 260. The two coterminal angles are 100 and negative 260. Okay, complementary angles. Complementary angles, sum of the angles is 90 degree. Find complement of each angle. What is the angle which added to 40? We get 90 degree. Okay, 40 plus what equal 90? So 40 plus 50 equal 90. So 50 is complement to 40. Okay. For 120, no complement. No way to add any number to 120 to get 90 degree. Because 120 greater than 90 degree. Supplementary angles mean sum of the angles are is 120. Okay, find the supplement of each angle 40 and 120. What is the angle supplement to 40? 40 plus what equal 120? 40 plus 140. So 140 is supplement to 40. 120 plus what equal 180? 120 plus 60 equal 180. So 60 is supplement to 120. Coterminal angle, that's the summary. Angle plus or minus 360 or one revolution or two revolution, whatever. To find a complementary angle, 90 minus the angle. To find supplementary angle, 180 minus the angle. Radian measure. 1 radian is the measure of the central angle theta. Okay, that is intercepts an arc S that is equal in length to the radius R of the circle. Circumference of any circle equal 2 by R. R is the radius of the circle. Okay, by dividing both sides by 2 by, so R equal C over 2 by, circumference over 2 by. So one revolution is equal 2 by. So 2 by is equivalent to 360. 360 is one revolution in degree, but 2 by is one revolution in radians. Okay, therefore 2 by in radian equivalent to 360, by in radian equal 180, by over 2 radian equivalent to 90 degree. Okay, here's some radians angle. Look at here. 0 equivalent to 0 degree, pi over 2 radian equivalent to 90 degree, pi radian equivalent to 180 degree, 3 pi over 2 radian equivalent to 270 degree, and finally 2 pi radian equivalent to 360 degree. Okay, let's add more. Pi over 4 radian, 3 pi over 4, 5 by over 5, 4, 7 by over 4, more common angle, okay, as shown. Okay, look at the quads. First quad, theta between, the value of theta is between 0 and by over 2. By over 2, we said before, equivalent to 90 degree. Theta is between pi over 2 and pi. Pi over 2 equivalent to 90 degree. Pi equivalent to 180. Third quad, theta is between pi and 3 pi over 2. by equivalent to 180 degree. 3 by over 2 is equivalent to 270 degree. 4 squared theta is between 3 by over 2 and 2 by. 3 by over 2 equivalent to 270 and 2 by equivalent to 360 degree. Okay, determine the quad of the terminal side of each. Pi over 3 is less than pi over 2, so lie in the first quad. 7 pi over 12, a little more than 6 pi over 12, or pi over 2, therefore second quad. Okay, negative pi over 3, a little more than 1 quad. So, lie on the third quad. Little more than one revolution. 360 plus. Little more. Okay, first quad. So, lie in first quad. Determine the quad of the terminal side of each given angle. Okay, try by yourself. Okay, this is the final answer. Coterminal angles using radian, we said before, we add or subtract one revolution. One revolution in degree equals 360. Here, one revolution equivalent to 2 pi. Okay, to find angle that is coterminal to a given angle theta, we add or subtract 2 pi. Find the coterminal angle for pi over 6. Pi over 6 plus 2 pi equal 13 pi over 6. Given coterminal angle, one positive and one negative, 13 pi over 4. By make subtract 13 pi over 4 minus 2 pi equal 5 pi over 4. Again, we take 5 pi over 4 minus 8 pi over 4 will equal let 2 pi. 8 pi over 4 equivalent to pi, 2 pi equal negative 3 pi over 4. Okay, the first negative angle. Okay, we can add 2 pi equivalent to 8 pi over 4 to make same denominator. Okay, plus equal 21 pi over 4. Give a coterminal angle, one positive and one negative. Okay, minus 2 pi equivalent to 10 pi over 5. So pi over 5 minus 10 pi over 5 equal negative pi 9 pi over 5. Or plus one revolution equivalent to 2 pi. 2 pi is 10 pi over 5. So pi over 5 plus 2 pi equal 11 pi over 5. Okay, find complement of each angle. 2 pi over 5 complement means sum of the two angles equal pi over 2. Pi over 2 equivalent to 90 degree. So pi over 2 minus 2 pi over 5 equal pi over 10. Supplement of each angle. 2 pi over 5. So pi 180. 180 minus the angle or equivalent to in radian pi minus 2 pi over 5 equal 3 pi over 5. Okay, find complement and supplement of each angle if possible. 2 pi over 3, let's try to get complement. Pi over 2 minus 2 pi over 3 equal negative pi over 6. So it doesn't have a complement angle. Okay. Supplementary angle, supplement angle by minus the angle equal by over 3. Summary. Coterminal angle, angle plus or minus 2 by complementary angle by over 2 minus the angle, supplementary angle by minus angle. Okay. To convert from degree into radian or from radian into degree, okay, we use these two relation. To convert 1 degree into radian times by over 180. If we want to convert from radian into degree, we times 180 and divided by pi. Convert 135 into radian times by over, we make times by over 180 to get 3 by over 4. Convert a negative 270 into radian times by over 180 equal negative 3 by over 2. Convert 9 by over 2 radian into degree, okay, times 180 over by equal 810. Convert to radian 2 radian into degree, 2 times 180 over by equal 114.59 degree. Okay, finally, the arc length. The relationship between arc length, radius, and central angle as shown in this triangle. Arc length equal radius times central angle. Radius equal arc length over central angle. Central angle equal arc length over radius. Okay. An example. A circle has a radius of 4 inch. Find the length of the arc intercepted by a central angle of 240. First, we change from degree into radian by times by over 180 equal 4 by over 3. Now we use our formula S equal R times theta. So S equal R equal 4. Radius equal 4, equal 4, and theta equal by 4 by over 3, so S equal 16.76 inch. Thank you and goodbye.